Hi, welcome to the second part of the crankshaft video tutorial, the variant with derive and parameters and a table. So I will have in the end an IPart which is controlled by a table. So let's have fun with inventor 18. Okay, that's where I left with my crankshaft. So I need some parameters. I will go to the base. No, that's the base body part. So let's go for a parameter. And I want to add numeric parameters. And one would be, let's see our names right here, the counter weight width. So I call it CV and width. Okay, and you always should put the same values right there which the model has at the moment. And you should always use user parameters. Don't change those names and don't try to make the formulas right here or insert the parameters right here. That would be not a good idea. So next user parameter should be the rod channel length. Rod channel length. At the moment, that's length, should be 40. Then add another numeric, that would be the inter main bearing channel, so it's the IMBJ, and at the moment this would be, of course, the length, sorry, this would be also length, okay, would be 40 millimeters. And for the moment I will do it with that parameters. So done. Then I will insert the parameters at the correct position in the model. So that width of the counterweight is in the extrusion 1. So you could go here to extrusion 1, or you could just open this and go to this extrusion, it's the same, and change this one, click right here, go to list parameters and choose the counterweight width and confirm. And those bodies should not change. That's sort of control. If you do it almost right, the model will not change. If you do it wrong, it certainly will change. So the length of those channels is in the sketch. So check out the first sketch. So this length should be the rod channel length. Confirm. Finish that sketch. Nothing changed. And the second one is in the inter main bearing channel in this sketch. That would be this 40. List the parameters and go for the inter main bearing channel. Okay. Finish that sketch. It's okay. Now I'm done here. I could save this. Now go to the combo. That's the combo. And you have to put your parameters into those move body commands. So this move body command is an offset of 60. That is the, you could just type it or you could go for the list. I will type them. So that would be the counterweight width plus, seems I misspelled it, or let's check if I delete this. This should get black. It doesn't, of course. You cannot use the parameters which you define there. So first you have to derive them. So we go for derive for the base solid part, open it, and I don't want those bodies, but I need those parameters. I could have derived them at the same moment where, no, I couldn't, because I just defined those parameters, so I could not use them before. So use the parameters and then want all those parameters into this model or part. Now I can use them. So let's go to the first move. Is there another one? No, there's only one move command, that's this one. And this should be the counterweight width plus, that was the rod journal length. So let's go for the list. Yeah, the rod journal length, and confirm. Nothing changed, that's nice. The second move command is just the counterweight width. Confirm. And this move command is two times the counterweight width plus the rod journal length plus misspelled it once again, plus the, let's go for a list, the IMBJ length. That's, I spelled this one wrong, that's great. Okay, and something is wrong, so I have to check it. Let's check the first one, that's the this length plus this length, yes. 42 is okay, so I did this one wrong, the last one, that's wrong, why? It should be, of course, it's just, I don't have to add this one. Okay, now it's okay. That's this width plus this length plus this width. That's the correct position. And that's the flange, and the flange would be sort of a different variable. I need the 120. So I will save this for the moment. Okay. Go back to my base solids. And I will introduce another parameter. Go for add numeric. That would be the combo length. Combo length. Length. And this would be a formula. This would be the CV width but two times plus the rod journal length. Let's spell it correct, length plus the inter main body journal length, and I misspelled this one, so I will misspell it here as well. IMBJ LN underline LN GTH, no GHT, I misspelled it. So let's check. This looks not good. That's okay. So this should be 120. And I'm done. Now let's go back to those combo. And I need that parameter. So I go for derive, not combo, but base solids. Open. Don't get those bodies, but I need a parameter, and I need this parameter, and those I don't need. So confirm, and now I can move this body by 5 times the combo length. Combo length like this, and confirm. Nothing changed, that's okay. So that's the combo step or phase. Now go for the complete one. Let's save this. Sorry. Okay, save it. I could check if it works. So go to the base bodies, go to the fix and change one of those numeric parameters, maybe the CV width to 30. So it changes here, done. It should change here as well after an update, and it should not quite change correct in this one right now, because these move commands are not yet parameterized. So okay, go back to the base. Sorry again, that's kind of awkward. Go for the fix and change this one back to 20. Done. Make an update for the combo, make an update for the complete one. So it's okay again. And I will close the fusion which I started accidentally. Okay, I need another parameter in this one, the combo. So I have to derive it. So go for derive once again. From the base solids, open, and I need, don't need those bodies, but I need a parameter. I need the combo length. I don't need the CV, I don't need the RG, I don't need the IMBG, but only the combo length, confirm. Now I could put this combo length into those move body commands. So this would be once the combo length. Okay. Next body would be 2 times the combo length. Combo length, and you have to remove those millimeters. The third would be 3 times the combo length. 3 times the combo length, and the last one for the move commands, not the rotate commands, is the move body 4, and this should be 4 times the combo length. Come on, length. So if I change now those values in the base solids part. Let's try once again. Let's use the rod channel length, this one. Make it 50. Done. Then go to the combo, make an update, go to the complete one and make an update, and you will see it changes accordingly and correct. Very nice. Go back to the base once and change this back to 40. Done. Change the combo, change the complete one. Okay, now I want to add a table. And I want to make this an iPod. So let's go for manage, or it's tool manage. And where is my iPod? Create iPod. And these lengths, I need only those three because the combo length is calculated, so I could move it back over there. So these three parameters should be in that table, that's okay. And now you could add there with the right mouse click a row and call this one. You should rename those members so you could identify the part from that name. So it's let's make the counterweight, let's say 30, the RG length 50, and the IMBG length 50 as well. And add another one, insert row, and make this smaller one, for example, 10. 30 and 30. At the moment you could not use every value because the limitations of because of the sketch and different other limits, but these should work. And confirm. And now we'll get a table right there. See? And with this table I could control the complete right here. So if I change this one to the smaller one and go to the complete one and make an update, see the complete crankshaft shrinks. And if you go to this one and go for, no, that's the wrong one, for this part and change it to the second one, go back to the complete one and make an update, you got a bigger one. Usually you would do the iPod in one part and not with derived parts, but that's a possibility and you might put it to good use. So hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my cat fan page. My Facebook cat fan page. Would be very nice of you to give me some more likes over there. And thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.